So what's up guys, so in today's tutorial we're gonna create this environment right here in Blender. It's kind of dark, not an animation, so please make sure to like and subscribe and let's get started. First off, when you open Blender you're gonna see this splash kind of screen. So first off we're gonna start by clicking on general, press A and press delete for deleting all, and shift A add a plane. I'm gonna scale it up, and now we're gonna add texture on it. You can either go to shading tab here, pull up the window and press and shader editor, press new, and now we're gonna get some. You have to go to this website textures.com and press browse library. Type in lava and press cool lava, and you have to download all of these images textures. If you want to pay, you can also pay for 4K or 8K, but I'm just gonna use the 1024 resolution. You're gonna see the free option here and press it and purchase all of these 6 textures and go to Blender and press the principal BSGF, control shift T, and then find the path where you put those textures, select all and principal texture setup. There we go, that is so easy, right? I'm gonna put it away. Now I'm gonna select from EV to cycles, from CPU to GPU. I mean, if you don't have a GPU, you can select CPU, but if you have a GPU, you have to select the GPU compute. Experimental, go to modifier, add subdivision surface, simple, adaptive subdivision. I'm gonna add some environment color. Look, there's our textures. Go to the material tab and go down, click on settings, click from bump quality to displacement and bump. Look at it and press control A and apply scale. And now we're gonna go into tab, pull the UV window, UV editor, click on UV editor, press A to select all. I'm gonna zoom out and scale it with S, scale it a little bit. Yeah, that's cool. Actually, as you can see, it's looping, right? The texture is actually looping. We're gonna add noise texture and put it right here. And now I'm gonna mix it with displacement. Press Ctrl, Shift, and right click and mix it with displacement. And now I'm gonna add detail of, I'm gonna add 20 in noise texture, 15 in details. Click on mix and expand it, and in a factor we're gonna add 1. Now as you can see, it's a little bit better. And now in the displacement we're gonna add, click on scale, 1.3, 10. That is actually great. I'm gonna save it, name whatever you want. And now I'm gonna control A and apply scale. I'm actually gonna tab and scale it up a little bit more. That is kind of cool, right? So I'm gonna add color ramp, add a color ramp, put it in roughness, and I'm gonna plug out the metallic and metallic it, and the metallic on one, and on the roughness I added color ramp, and on the black portion I'm gonna add point 430 kind of. Yeah, that's kind of cool. So now I'm gonna add a plane for water. Add plane, scale it up, move it down just a little bit, and that's kind of cool. Just a little bit more. Press new on the material, and I'm gonna click on roughness, and I'm gonna type 0.3, not 0.3, 0.03, and click on transmission and add one. And on the color, I'm gonna click on the color, and I'm gonna have the black and have the white, kind of gray, and it's actually looking so cool. So now I'm gonna add a plane. If they add a plane, G and Z to move it up, or X 90, scale it down just like that. S and Z for scale it upwards, scale with it, scale it with X, move it up, scale it a bit more. I'm gonna move it Y direction, G and Y, move it a bit up. Now I'm gonna add it a material. Click on the plane, 0.2, click new, and click on this green dot and add emission. I'm gonna give it a 10. Now I'm gonna go front and shift D, and I'm gonna duplicate it and move it just right here. Yeah, it's kind of cool. So now we're gonna change the environment from white to black. Wow, look at it, it's actually looking so cool. I'm gonna select three of the plane, move it down, now I'm gonna add a bit of the volume. I'm gonna add a volume on the water. I wanna make it a little bright. Shift A, add a cube, scale it with X, scale it with Y, and I'm gonna scale it down with S and Z. Just right there. Click on new. Delete the principal BHDF. If they add a volume, volume scatter, and take this wire and put it in volume. Look at it. It's giving a volume kind of foggy vibe. I'm gonna select the plane and give it 20. go in the front, shift A, add a camera, control alt and 0 for the camera view. And I'm gonna move it right here, move it down. I'm gonna rotate it and it's cool. And for the water, click and grab it up a little bit. And select the cube, move it up. Yeah, look at it. It's actually looking kind of cool. I'm actually going to give it a 0.5 on the density of volume shader, 0.5. It's giving a great look. Yeah, that's cool. And I'm gonna click on shift, press on shift A, add a cube, move it up, move it back, scale it with S and X, S and Z for scale it up, S and Y for scale it. Go to the render view. I'm gonna create new principal DBSDF, delete, and add a volume scatter and put it on our volume. And now I'm actually gonna give it a 0.05, and that is looking cool. Save it. And now I'm gonna add a little bit more lights. Shift A, add a plane, move it up, R X 90, R Z 90, scale it down, scale it up, move it back a little bit, Shift D, move it on the right, left side and the right side, press new. Press new on the material, add an animation material, 10 here, and give it a red material. And on the right side, I'm gonna click on new, give it an emission material, give a blue kind of material, right there, and give it a 20. Go to camera view. Go to render, and now I'm actually gonna move it a little bit close. Also the red one. It is actually looking kind of cool. So there you go, we render it. I'm gonna put on the max samples on 800 and on the render setting I give it 1920 and 1080 for 1080p good resolution. And I'm gonna select the JPEG and quality 100%. So there you go, we created this environment right here. So it's kind of cool. Okay, so that's it for today's video. If you liked the video, make sure to give the thumbs up, make sure to like and subscribe. If you have any question, you can comment down below. And I just created my Patreon. If you need project file, you can purchase the Patreon and get the project file for free. and I'll see you in the next video. See ya.